guide to build the ultimate iPad productivity desk setup or Mac desk setup and
top
some tips and tricks. So stay tuned towards the end
for
things you should know so you don't have any mishaps. The Apple Silicon MacBook Pro, and it's amazing, she really likes it a lot. It's powerful enough to do really powerful things like Premiere Pro and Photoshop and 3D graphics animations and all sorts of stuff. So you're not going to run into an issue. Of course, you have iPads because iPad productivity, guys. But
the iPad Pro.
In the new iPad Pro, especially since it's not like most people need 16 gigs of RAM on their iPad. So this one you can save a couple hundred dollars off. And you can also get the 11-inch iPad Pro, but I found the 12.9-inch one. Especially now with the specs being the same as the new iMacs and Mac Mini, you can really get a good amount of work done. You can do 8K graphics content and really push it. Or build the ultimate iPad productivity desk setup. Thunderbolt cable, because an iPad Pros have Thunderbolt in them, which I'll have some of my favorite Thunderbolt accessories on iPad Pro later on in the video, so stay tuned. But 2-meter one is what I would generally recommend, and a 2-meter cable is plenty long enough to go and like reach across the hallway. Then Apple Pencil, because Apple Pencil, guys, Apple Pencil is amazing, especially for artists or students. It allows you to take notes and mark up documents from your lectures in class, or making these thumbnails for YouTube videos, or graphics design for those multimedia students out there, because you can get really fine pointer control and map things to it. All the USB-C, or now Thunderbolt 3 and Thunderbolt 4 devices. I would recommend the iPhone, and hits that balance of price to performance and price to features that most people would want. And it comes in lots of colors, guys, because who doesn't like colors? My favorite keyboard slash maybe my favorite accessory for the iPad Pro, both 11-inch and 12.9-inch, is the Smart Keyboard Folio. Especially as a student, it allows you to have keyboard shortcuts and navigate things, especially with the new version of iPadOS. It has so many more keyboard shortcuts for navigation and usage that it's amazing, and it's great for productivity. It can easily 10x your productivity. And if you spill on it, you can pretty much just wipe it off, so you don't have to worry about getting crumbs in your keyboard or anything like that. And then my second favorite case is the Zag case. It's really nice. It has neodymium magnets in the inside, so you can fold it out. It has all these adjustment angles, and so you can adjust it to wherever you want. So it's great for drawing or things like that, or typing if you do all your typing on the digital keyboard, because I'm still a person who also likes typing on the digital keyboard because it has its usability benefits and accessibility benefits for productivity and work at home and all those things. But it's also soft and very protective. It has stout rubber bumpers around the entire thing, so you don't have to worry about it. And a spot for your Apple Pencil. Hold it right here, but it also has a slot right here that fits really well. And the magnets from the iPad still work through this because it's thin enough. So it just like slides on and it won't come off, but it has little bits of rubber on the sides. It's still easy to get off. I was never a wired headphones person until I tried these. So I'm gonna give you a whole bunch of different options for headphones, from more budget friendly and truly wireless to the best over ear headphones, the Sennheiser HD 820s. So if you're more of an earbuds person, I would recommend the Sennheiser IE 800s or the Clips X6Is. Both these are amazing. These are a little bit more expensive, but these cover basically anything you'd want from a pair of IEMs or earbuds driven through your iPhone or your iPad Pro. Then you can get the lossless audio to wireless headphones. These two are my top two favorite picks for wireless headphones. The Apple AirPods with wireless charging case. These are my favorite earbuds. They're super accessibility friendly, and I'm a big proponent of accessibility. They're also super comfortable. If you haven't tried them, I would recommend it. But if you're not a fan of those, or you want something that's active noise canceling, that's truly wireless, I would recommend these are the AirPods Pro. They're great. They're active noise canceling. They're in ear instead of on ear, where the other ones just rest on the top of the ear right here, which makes these, if you're eating food, kind of a little rawr. They're also IP67 dust and waterproof. Both those, especially if you're in the Apple ecosystem, accessibility friendly, having crazy battery life. For a budget friendly, amazing over ear headphone, has the option of being wireless. Audio Technica ATH M50X BTs. BT stands for Bluetooth. These are already a standard, and for YouTubers, you probably know most of your favorite YouTubers use these. Marques Brownlee has used the Sennheiser HD 820s or the Audio Technica ATH M50s for most of his YouTubing career. And they're super comfortable, and they have amazing audio fidelity, especially for the price. Their normal price is $200. They hit
way above
to what they cost. They're both amazing. Now guys, SSDs, because storage guys, you need to be able to store all your homework assignments and movies and videos and all those things. The two sets of SSDs that I would recommend, budget friendly and then more expensive, but Thunderbolt SSD I was introduced to by Peter McKinnon is my favorite SSD for, I've used a lot of SSDs or solid state drives as they're also known as, but this one's my favorite. It's Lice Rugged Pro SSD. I have the link in the description, Thunderbolt 3/Thunderbolt 4, and it does USB. So if you're wanting to plug it into your iPad or your new iPad Pro that is Thunderbolt, it's IP67 dust and water resistant, and it's insanely fast. You can transfer huge project files like 200 gigs almost instantaneous. A well-known one that most people have heard of, this one is the one that MKBHD generally uses, but they're both amazing. And this one's the Samsung X5 Thunderbolt 3/Thunderbolt 4 portable SSD, and it has insane read write speed. Now you can use these with all sorts of things like the new MacBook Pro or things like that. I've wanted this for so long. The newest version of iPadOS has a file transfer indicator, so you can tell how long a file is going to transfer for, but it's not really an issue with a Thunderbolt SSD. And now that the USB 4 spec, now you can use these with all sorts of USB things. Those are my two favorite Thunderbolt accessories. So if you're looking for Thunderbolt accessories, check those out. They're amazing. I love them. And then of course, you're gonna need some peripherals for your Mac or your iPad to build the ultimate iPad productivity desk setup or Mac desk setup. So these are my three picks. You could go with the Keychron K2 if you like mechanical keyboards, but I always group typing and touchscreen. So this is what I found is it's a good middle ground. Apple's Magic Keyboard with numpad, it's amazing. You can map the other keys to separate actions, and especially with the new version of iPadOS and macOS, use a virtualized KVM switch, which if you don't know what that means, that you can connect your Mac and iPad Pro or something like that and switch between it, and you don't need two sets of keyboards and mouse and trackpads, because that's what I generally do. I actually have three, one for each of my iPads and then school stuff because I'm a college student. Magic Trackpad 2, this is amazing. This allows you to turn your Mac computer or your sister's Mac computer into a much larger touch area to do gestures for somebody who works on an iPad. Makes it more user-friendly and intuitive, especially since you can do most of the gestures now from your iPad to the Mac or the Mac to the iPad. And then Magic Mouse, this is my favorite mouse. I know Magic Mouse is controversial and you can do gestures swiping up and down and horizontal on the timeline for when you're doing video editing or scrolling through your papers or books or things like that. And it can do right click, left click, and all sorts of stuff. I really like this. Tip, if you don't want to spend the money for the Magic Mouse 2, get the Magic Mouse 1. You need a mouse. Mouse is a specific pointer device. If not, I would probably recommend the MX Master series from Logitech. But this is great because if you're going to be sitting all day or walking or whatever you're going to be doing at your desk, you want it to look nice. So talking about that, a good monitor I would recommend is the HP Z31X. That one's my favorite monitor. I've tried a lot of monitors, but that one is amazing. It's Cinema 4K, which is more pixels than a standard 4K. It has an actual KVM switch in it. It can do active scaling, so you can put a view from your iPad into the monitor and it can rescale like the Apple TV. Tip, if you want to hook up the Apple TV to your TV, you can AirPlay to your Apple TV and then it'll automatically rescale it to fit. So that's great for your Zoom calls during work at home. You can use your iPhone for the Zoom call and connect this. This is Apple's camera connection kit adapter. Right here is power, and then you have a USB-A port for data. It'd be nice if it was USB-C, but that's whole nother conversation. This is great. So if you're looking at dongles, check out one of those. Then another dongle I would recommend a lot for students is a Thunderbolt 3/Thunderbolt 4 to DisplayPort and Thunderbolt 2 adapter. So you can plug it into your iPad or MacBook Pro or iPad Pro. Then the three dongles that I would recommend that everybody should have that aren't those: a Belkin USB-C to Ethernet adapter, 10 gigabit Ethernet, or just gigabit Ethernet. So either USB-A or Thunderbolt. These are my two very favorite dongles, other than the Apple camera connection kit adapter. This is Apple's multi-port adapter. I've never heard of anybody having an issue with an Apple dongle. Well, I've heard tons of horror stories about people using third-party dongles that are like cheap dongles, killing their computer. This one's really good. It has HDMI, can do Cinema 4K, which is important. And it has a USB-A port and a USB-C port. And then this is my favorite third-party dongle. It has all the ports you'd pretty much need. This one isn't Thunderbolt, but it's USB, but it's plenty fast. It has all the ports you would want. Full speed USB-A, power USB-C, UHS 2 card reader for micro and regular SD cards, which is worth the cost of this would be by itself. This is actually very reasonably priced and budget friendly. Really much recommend this one as the budget pick. If you're interested, check it out. It has basically any port that you would need. Check it out. Amazon has a great returns policy. That goes for all of these things. This is the world's best-selling audio interface. It's the Scarlett 2i2 Gen 3 audio interface. They have a Thunderbolt version of this one that's great also, but I haven't really found that much of a difference between the Thunderbolt and non-Thunderbolt one, other than the line level signal coming out of it, which basically line level signal is the signal coming in from your microphone. I really recommend this microphone. It's the Rode PodMic, $100. It really takes those Zoom calls that you're taking and FaceTime calls now, because now you can do scheduling FaceTime to Android and Windows users, which is amazing. That it's really awesome. It's built like a tank. It's all metal all around, and then stand. I really like this. I'll have the stand and my favorite XLR cable in the video description, so check that out if you're looking for the best stand. These are all reasonably priced. So, of course, if you don't want to have a whole audio interface and all those things, and you want to just upgrade your Zoom calls for like $20 or $30, make your Zoom calls amazing, check these things out. TaxStar SGC5. 98. It's only $20 and it has 90% of the performance of the Rode Pro Plus microphone. Although, if you want to plug this into your iPhone or iPad without running it through like audio interface or something like that, I would recommend this. This allows you to take any microphone pretty much and convert it into a signal that your iPad or iPhone or Windows computer would understand. It's the Rode SC4. It's a TRS to TRRS adapter. Basically, it takes the signal format from here, would go into a mirrorless camera or something like that, into something that your iPhone or iPad or Mac or Windows computer or even Chromebook would understand. And so you don't have to deal with terrible audio quality, because audio is more than half of video. Because somebody will sit through not very good looking lecture or video or something like that, but they will be annoyed if you have terrible audio. We've all experienced that as students. This is amazing. It is a active HDMI cable, which has cinema 4K and can do high refresh rate because it's HDMI 2.1. It can do 120 hertz and then it goes into USB-C on the other side. And it's active cable, so you don't have to worry about signal degradation. And it can do 8K video resolution. Of course, the iPads don't currently output 8K, and there's very few monitors that have that. But and it's very reasonably priced, especially right now. It's a great deal. The Boya BYM microphone. This is generally $20, but it's even less right now. It's an insane lavalier microphone for the price. As long as you wire it up properly, it sounds amazing. And that's coming from a multimedia student and somebody who's done a significant amount of audio engineering. The only thing I would say, you need either USB-C to headphone jack or headphone jack to lightning adapter for your phone. But the cool thing about this one is it can do regular TRS signal and TRRS signal, so that you could plug it into an audio recorder or something like that. The audio recorder would automatically understand, or plug it right into your DSLR or mirrorless camera, or you just flip the switch, and spending this $20 could really affect your audio quality for your Zoom and work at home and all those things. So my favorite battery bank, that when I'm filming or needing to run an audio interface and all my other equipment, or power MacBook Pro a couple times, and this one would allow her to charge her Apple Silicon MacBook Pro a couple times, which is amazing. And it's USB-C PD, so it does full power delivery, and it has USB-A for charging, and it has Qi charging and can do the full Qi charging, and you can do all of them at the same time. And then I got this on Amazon and it's amazing. If you're looking for a Qi charging USB-C battery bank, check out some options I'll have in the video description that I found that are good. This is an amazing case. I really like cases. They're a little expensive, but they work great. Not just protect your device inside, which it's super nice and soft. They should make pillows. It's so soft and comfortable, or fuzzy blankets. It also works great as a mouse pad. I found the black ones work amazing for a mouse pad. So you can store your iPad or all your accessories So your AirPods, your Magic Mouse, your Magic Trackpad, and all those things inside of it, and just take them all out. And this prevents it from getting scratched. So if you're getting for the Magic Mouse and all those things, get the 12-inch one, which is the in-case Mac sleeve or something like that. I'll have it in the video description. It's really well for the MacBook Pro, and it also incidentally works for the iPad Pro, even with Smart Keyboard Folio or Magic Keyboard on it, which Magic Keyboard, Smart Keyboard Folio, matter of personal preference. And then this is amazing. Iographer makes great things, and those are a little bit more expensive, but this one's the Unit Digi, and it has 4 cold shoe mounts, and then it has quarter 20 mounts on it, right here, and right here for attaching to a tripod. Works great for your phone. You can fit an iPhone with a moment case and an anamorphic lens, plus a UV or ND filter adapter and a UV or ND filter over top of it. It's really sturdy, and it will protect your phone, so if it does have something happen, it's a hard shell. Protect your phone. It's like $20, so check that out. Link in the video description for all the affiliated things I'm talking about, of course, if you're interested in any of the things I'm talking about. Aperture Imran FL, this is my favorite mobile light to make those Zoom calls amazing, and it has an amazing CRI. Basically, CRI is a measure of the color for photography and videography, which this can do DTAP power, a USB-C power, so you can power off a battery bank like this one, which is what I generally do for those Zoom calls, so you can have a well-lit camera, because even a not very good camera like a webcam or your laptop camera looks so much better when you're properly lit. And this one has a very good diffusion, so you're not gonna get like way blown out on one side and it'd be like all harsh and shadows and be like, ah. But it also can do tungsten and daylight, and it's amazing. If you're looking for a light, I really recommend Aperture's products. They're really good quality. This is amazing. And it comes in a really nice carrying case. So you get the light, and it can do battery packs, so you Sony MP batteries, and they just slide on. And it has a really good control, so you can control it. It can do 100 to 0 all the way up, and it has both daylight and tungsten lights. It's bi-color, and it has lots of tripod mounts to put things on. So it's great. You can put it on a tripod, or it comes with adapters for a quarter 20 and 3/8 and all sorts of other things to put it on boom arms and anything else you would want. And it's pretty reasonably priced generally. If you're trying to upgrade your Zoom calls, or you do a lot of conferences or YouTube or anything like that, I would recommend that light, because it's powerful enough to be your key light. It's the year for building out your iPad or your Mac setup, your work at home desk. And then the Joby Gorilla Pod, you can get the legs separately from the head if you want. The bundles generally as a total are a good deal if it's all Joby products. Make sure that if it's a tech item, like, make sure it's not bundled an older version with a newer thing, so they'll bundle an old thing like a light or something else, and then they'll list the original MSRP even though it's no longer sells for that. So make sure you watch out for that. But for tripods, I really like this. These are bendy. These are one of my favorite tripods. If you're looking to get a mobile tripod, I really recommend this. Or the Peak Design tripod, I would also highly recommend it. If you're looking for more than just a desktop tripod and you want a full tripod, I would recommend the Peak Design tripod, the carbon fiber or aluminum one. Those are both amazing. I'll have all the affiliated things linked in the video description. And so check those out, and all the different things. Makes it easier for you. If you're interested in any of these things, just tap that link. It'll bring you right there. Leave your comments down below. What did you find that you love, or what are you looking for, and how can I help? Don't forget to like, share, and like it if you liked it, because it really does help.
YouTube thinks you'll like this video.